I'm not like, so he came and he was like, let's go to dinner. And I was like, okay, just like text me where, like kept it really cool. And he sat down, he had like four phones. He was saying like El Chapo was watching me. And I was like, okay, like cool. He had a
El
boat.
Chapo was a gang or was El
No, El Chapo ran the
cartel.
And we were in his car. He was playing me his new album. He was on Instagram Live. And in my brain, I'm like, dude, he shows me on live. And I'm like, ugh, I just know one of like the fans from Iowa, like where
like,
I'm from.
That
like,
is a dude.
Yeah, like that's a back in the mail. And it was just one of those situations where I almost felt like I was like at like lunch with my or like in trouble with my principal. Mm-hmm. Like I felt like he was literally looking so deep into like my soul and my like nine different holes that like I didn't even know what I was getting into. I tried caviar for the first time. That was cute. It was hot. He asked like, do you want to come home with me? He was kind of just like, get in my car.
And then you just kind of, I mean, that's how they always are.
You don't ask, you go.
Yeah, you just go. Yeah. You just follow the rules. And I don't know. He's all about like energy, like ashwagandha, yeah. Like the whole nine. Honestly, we fucked. And I told him I was trans, like mid, like spread eagle, like pussy flap scars and all. Like I literally.
How did you like, how did you bring that
honestly,
up?
Honestly,
like,
I was just
mid-sex.
Black.
What?
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm squirting. He's like, no, you're not. No. Oh my god, you guys kill me. But no, I was literally, I'm not kidding, like spread eagle. I think he was like eating me out or something, and then in my brain he like stopped and I'm like, oh,
oh he
knows my clit looks different, like fuck. Like I was like, fuck, what's about to happen? And he was like, yeah, no. He's not out of breath that quick. Let me get this man an oxygen tank. But he was like, can I ask you something? And I go, yeah? And he was like, are you trans? And I go, I was just
like,
I was so drunk.
No,
like,
come
like,
on.
They're like,
what makes me give you that idea?
And I was laying there and I go, you caught me. And he literally was like, baby, I don't give a fuck. God raised all of us equal, yeah, all this stuff. Yeah. And I was like, that respect makes you so much more attractive and that makes you so much more like, honestly, manly and hot that you like, that you know that I had to work harder and pay more than all these other fucking crusty dust. I was like, I'm not like, so he came. All
right, hold
was
on.
Like,
let me point out something about this video. I'm gonna go ahead and say it, right? Isn't that RAP? You know what? I can't say it. YouTube might falsely flag this video, but isn't that like sexual assault or straight up the R word? You know, I mean, maybe I'm wrong. Y'all comment below, but this dude or him, they, it, whatever they use the pronouns, right? He just said that after Kevin Gates allegedly put his mouth down on you, he asked this question. And I'm glad you told him, but why didn't you tell him from jump when you was in the car with him? Or at the dinner table, whatever y'all was at, eating and shit. Why didn't you tell him? So that's the R word. Like, afterwards you gonna tell him? And allegedly he went along with it. All right, but now you exposing this man. But y'all get upset when the heterosexual community don't look at y'all as such. It's a few gay people or LGBTQ people that doesn't even look at y'all as real females. I'm really trying to be careful so this video doesn't get flagged. So bear with me. But all right, you exposing him. Okay. And then on top of that, you bragging about it. And in the last statement you said, you was like, yeah, I find it hot that he realized I had to go through more than the regular females. Hold on, let me play it so I can make sure I heard him right. Hold on.
And he literally was like, baby, I don't give a fuck. God raised all of us equal, yeah, all this stuff. And I was like, that respect makes you so much more attractive and that makes you so much more like, honestly, manly and hot that you like, that you know that I had to work harder and pay more than all these other fucking crusty dust. All
right, you said crusty dusties. I don't know what that equates to. I don't know how to break that lingo down. I don't know, maybe crusty dusty is like slang for real females, but maybe it's not. So I'm not gonna put that on you, that you're trying to say that you had to go through more than a real woman. So I'm gonna X that out. But the story you just told, ma'am, sir, they, them, whatever, the story you told, you admit to R-wording this dude. Y'all comment below. Let me know what y'all think. I'm hoping this story isn't true, but it's believable. And the reason why, because a lot of y'all have been known to trick dudes and shit, you know, which is very dangerous. You're lucky Kevin Gaytes did not do what a lot of other dudes would have done, you know? But I still don't want to believe it, but it's possible. But I want to know what the LGBTQ community, what y'all think about this? This person talking about how he tricked Kevin Gaytes. And then he confessed, like, while he was already doing what they do. I'm signing off. Port City Black TMZ. Make sure y'all subscribe, man. Hit that bell. Share. You dig?
Hell, she's all I got. So I refuse to cheat and break her heart. Yeah,